Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunkhe and welcome to the x86 assembly. So, till now we have seen how one function calls another function and how the function returns to another function. Have you ever wondered what happens when a function has a local variable, how the stack behaves? Now, let's see what happens when function has a local variables. In this video, we will see our C program in a Visual Studio. So, let's get started. This is my C program. First, we are including stdio.h file. After that, we'll go to the main. Main has a one local variable named a. It is an integer type, so integer a equals 1, it has a value 1. After that, main has a second variable known as a b and it has a value 2. After that, main is calling function. Now we are in function. Function has first variable integer x and the value of that variable is 3. Second variable is y, integer y, value of that variable is 4. After that, function is returning with the b's. It will return to main. And now main will return with the age. I have set some project properties for this program. So if you want to know how to set a project properties, I'll give the link of that video in the I button above. Now we want to build the program. For that, click on build, build solution. Build is succeeded. Now we'll click here to set a breakpoint. Now click on debug, right click here and click on go to disassembly. As we can see, this arrow indicates the next instruction to be executed. Okay. First instruction is push EBP. The value from the EBP will get pushed onto the stack because that is a stack frame pointer of a function who called main. Let's execute that instruction by clicking step into. After that, now we want to set main stack frame onto the stack. For that, what we will do, we will move address pointed by the ESP into the EBP. Okay. Let's step into that. As we can see, address pointed by the ESP is now into the EBP. So in a C program, we are defining two variable names A and B. For that, compiler will allocate two double over space onto the stack. Okay. For that, we are using subtract instruction. What happens when we execute this instruction? ESP will be get subtracted by the 8. Currently, ESP is pointing at the 0012FF68. Let's execute the instruction. For that, click on step into. As we can see, 8 bytes have been subtracted from the stack to allocate a space for two variables. Now, next C segment is we are defining integer A with the value 1. For that, what we will do? We will move 1 into the space allocated by the compiler for that variable. Let's tap into that. As we can see, 1 has been moved here. Next instruction is we are moving 2 into the other allocated space onto the stack. Let's tap into that. As we can see, 2 is onto the stack. Now in the C program, main is calling function. And its assembly equivalent is call function. For that, what we will do? We will move next instruction's address onto the stack because when function will finish its execution, it can return to main using that address onto the stack. Let's tap into that. As we can see, the next instruction's address got moved onto the stack and we have passed control to the function. And now we are executing from function. The first instruction is push EBP. That means main stack frame pointer will be pushed onto the stack. Step into that. As we can see, main stack frame pointer is onto the stack. Next instruction is move ESP into the EBP. That means now we will set function stack frame onto the stack. Step into that. Okay. The address pointed by the ESP is now into the EBP, and as we can see from this point, it is all function stack frame onto the stack. Now in the function also we are defining two variables. For that, compiler will allocate space onto the stack, and to allocate space onto the stack, what we will do, we will subtract 8 bytes from the ESP. Let's tap into that. As we can see, this space is allocated by the compiler for the two variables. Next C statement is integer x equals 3. That means we are defining an integer variable and giving it a value 3. And for that, assembly equivalent is move 3 into the space allocated by the compiler. Step into that. As we can see, 3 has been moved onto the stack. Next C statement is we are defining integer y equals 4. For that, we will move 4 into the other space allocated by the compiler onto the stack. Step into that. And as we can see, 4 has been moved onto the stack. Next C statement is function is returning with the beads. For that, what we will do, we will move beads into the EAX. Let's step into that. As we can see, beads has been moved into the EAX. Now, next C statement is we are closing function here. The function has set some variables onto the stack and it is function's responsibility to clean up the stack. For that, we will move EBP into the ESP. That means ESP will be moved 8 bytes down and the space allocated for that variable will be cleared. As we can see, EBP is 0012FF58 and ESP is 0012FF50. So those two elements will be cleared from the stack. Step into that. Okay, as we can see, those two elements has been cleared onto the stack and now ESP is putting it to the 0012FF58. Now function is returning to the main. For that, we have to give the main stack frame pointer back and it is stored onto the stack. We will pop that value and put that into the EBP. Let's step into that. As we can see, the top of the stack has been popped into the EBP. Next, we are returning to the main. Now what will the return instruction do? It will take the value pointed by the ESP from the stack and it will put that into the EIP and EIP will begin execution from there. Okay, so the value pointed by the ESP is 00401039. That will be put into the EIP and EIP will begin execution from there. Step into that. Okay, as we can see, we have backed into the main and we have backed into the same address which we took from the stack. Now main is returning with the A's. For that, we will move those A's into the EAX. Step into that. Okay, A's has been moved into the EAX. Now next C statement is main is ending here. Main has two variables, so it is now main's responsibility to clear the stack because those are local variables of a main. For that, what we will do, we will move value from the EBP to the ESP. EBP is currently 0012FF68 and ESP is currently 0012FF60. So we will move EBP into ESP and the space allocated for the two variables will be get cleared. Let's tap into that. Okay, as we can see, we have cleared those two variables. Now main is returning to the initialization function who called it. For that, what we will do, we will give back its own stack frame pointer back. So value pointed by the ESP will be moved into the EBP. Step into that. As we can see, EBP's value got changed and now main is returning to the function who called it. For that, it will take the address from the top of the stack and it will put that into the EIP and EIP will begin execution from there. Let's step into that. And as we can see, we have written to the initialization function. That's what I had planned for this video. In the next video, we will see the same program in an animation format to get a better understanding of how the local variables works. Thank you.